Today, we're going to be going over the absolute best way to make money in GTA 5 Online this week. It's extremely fun. You guys can make hundreds of thousands of dollars, and hands down, it is better than doing the air freight cargo missions by yourself. I'm telling you, this is the best way to make money in GTA 5 this week. I hope you guys do go on to enjoy the video. If you do, be sure to smash a like on it, subscribe if you are new to the channel, and don't forget to check out Digazani if you guys do need any money in GTA 5 Online. With that said, I hope you enjoy the video, and without further ado, let's get it started. First things first, you guys can make upwards of $30,000 per round this week by winning an Overtime Rumble. That's right, normally it's 10K, now you can make $30,000 per round. So I'm going to be sharing a few tips and tricks with you guys on how you can actually win practically every single round. Whenever I play this game mode, I almost never lose. It's a 99% chance. After watching this video, you're going to win practically every single round. So I hope you enjoy. And let's get into some of these tricks. First off, let's talk about how you can jump. Normally you have 30 seconds to jump from the ramp to get on to the play area. Now if you guys want to use the most amount of time possible, you can actually jump right off the top of the platform at exactly the 13 or the 14 second mark, and you'll make it into the play area with 1 second to spare. The reason why you'd want to do that is just so you can be the last person to land, and then you can wipe out other enemies that are already on the platform, netting you guys more points. The next way that you can jump is by driving off the platform as you would normally, but just before you get to the bottom and launch off into the air, what you guys can actually do is jump using this car, and you'll gain a little bit of extra air time, and it'll just make it a little bit easier. It's the method I use every single time I actually play this game mode, and I would suggest trying it out. One of the tricks you can use while playing this game mode is, of course, jumping off the very top and coasting straight into the play area from the very top of the ramp. This means you'll be extremely high up in the air. And some people just go and fly around in a circle and take a lot of time, and it really annoys the people playing the game, but that's not what I'm telling you guys to do. What you should try doing is doing this exactly, but then going at it from an angle at the sides and kind of being like a kamikaze. It doesn't matter if you die, what you're trying to do is eliminate the other team from being on the platform so you can hit them from an angle and smash them right off the platform, and you might even end up landing on the platform, surviving, and knocking them off, making it a perfect plan. Another thing you can try to do is being the first person on the platform. The second you get the chance to drive, drive right off the ramp and try to get to the platform right away, especially if it's a game mode that looks like this, because then you can get there early and other cars will have to try to hit you off and they might end up failing. Also, when playing this game mode, you want to make sure you set the round limit to a high amount of rounds. You can see I have it set here to 4, and also the amount of attempts to a high amount as well, because the more attempts that you have during each round means more money per round, and the more money you make per round means more money in the end, and it's triple money in RP, so you guys can make a killing from this, so make sure you have a high round win limit and a high amount of attempts. If you see somebody on the opposite team sitting like this at the edge, tell somebody you're playing with if you're communicating with them on a headset to just tap you from the back lightly, and then it'll knock them right off the side so then they don't get those 5 points. Also, don't be this guy that just goes around flying around the entire time, because in all honesty, yeah, it can help you out, but in reality, it just makes each round take a lot longer, and if everybody just landed right away, you'll still make the exact same amount of money, it's just the game will go by quicker, and you'll just make more money in the end. Instead of making each round like a minute, minute and a half, they could really be 30 seconds. So if you're one of those people that flies around in a circle, I would suggest not to, and just trying to land on the platform would be your best bet. Also, there is a chance you might screw up really, really badly. You go off the ramp, you spin out or something, and you manage to get to the bottom of the ramp, and you think you're just gonna give up because you're not gonna be able to make it. That's not right. You could literally sit at the very bottom of the ramp, get absolutely no speed, go 10 miles an hour off the actual ramp, and open up your parachute, and just glide over to the platform. Because if you guys pull up on your analog stick, you'll just glide there, and you won't actually gain any altitude or lose any altitude, you'll stay at that exact same altitude. So if you guys just continuously glide and pull up on your analog stick, you'll make it to the platform guaranteed 100% of the time. Just make sure you're always pulling up and not pushing down. Guys, if you follow every single thing I told you in this video, you will be able to win 99% of the overtime rumble games that you play. And I was even wrong. You can make even more than I thought you could. This game that I was playing, we played four rounds. We won four rounds and lost two rounds, seven attempts per round. And we made $207,000 and 22,000 RP. That is absolutely insane. You guys can do it too just by following all the instructions I told you in this video, and you guys will be able to make that amount as well. Hands down, the best way to make money this week. It's one of the most fun adversary modes you can play in GTA 5 and one of the most profitable ones as well. Thank you guys for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed. If you do want to see more content like this, be sure to drop a like and subscribe if you're new, and I will catch you guys in the next video.